I'm Andrea Carter here with veteran sports broadcaster Brenda VanLengen, and we are talking about a documentary series called If Not For Them, about women's basketball in the 50s, 60s, 70s, and the very important women and people that took part in laying the foundation for the game that we have today. And I want to get into just one of the episodes, and it's actually mentioned in a couple, but just something that stood out to me. Title IX passed in 1972. We're supposed to make things equal, you know, for women and as far as sports goes as well. But the NCAA didn't take over until 1982. So I'm just curious, what did women's basketball look like in that 10-year gap where we had Title IX, but the NCAA wasn't helping at all?
Right. It was a time when the NCAA wasn't interested in women's sports. They told the women leaders of that time they weren't interested in women's sports. So it took a group of women from pockets all over the country to come together and form their own organization, the AIAW. And they had the governance structure, the recruiting rules, the qualification for a national tournament. They had to put it all together on their own.
So the AIAW, you mentioned different pockets. You know, what were some of the teams that were competing in the AAU?
Yeah, a lot of people don't know who the teams were that won during that stretch, because we hear the NCAA results and the NCAA records, but we don't hear about those women in the AIAW. So you had Immaculata, had a three-year run. They were a private women-only college in Pennsylvania that won the first three AIAW. Then Delta State came along out of Cleveland, Mississippi.
They
were
coached. South.
That's right.
There we go.
They were coached by Margaret Wade, who the Wade Trophy is named after. And Lucy Harris was their star. Then you had UCLA, Annie Myers, who played for UCLA. Billy Moore was the coach, who also coached the 76 Olympic team. And then Old Dominion, which I think this is a great story. Marianne Crawford Stanley, who's still coaching in the WNBA, played for Immaculata those first three championships. And then just a couple of years later, she's the head coach at Old Dominion, and they win the national championship. So there's one of the stories. And then the last AIAW championship before the NCAA stepped in, Louisiana Tech won. And then Rutgers won the last one when there were two championships.
Got it. Okay, you mentioned Marianne Stanley, who still coaches today. Are there any other women who maybe we know today, but we don't know that they were involved, you know, either they played or they, you know, are there any more of those women that we're going to hear about?
There's absolutely so many. I mean, Kathy Rush was the head coach for Immaculata, and she had basketball camps that she conducted for years. And people like Debbie Ryan, who went on to Virginia, Gino Auriemma, you might have heard of, coached at her camps as well. And so there are so many people that came out of that coaching tree as well. You know, and then Billy Moore, who was our first Olympic coach, she coached Pat Summitt. And then she actually recommended to USA Basketball that Pat Summitt was one of the rising stars that should get involved with international coaching. And so, you know, there's that tie. And then with Louisiana Tech, Sanja Hogue started that program, and one of her prize recruits that was out of the state of Louisiana was none other than Kim Mulkey.
And okay, you mentioned Sanja Hogue and Kim Mulkey. We have to give her flowers because obviously just an incredible coach. But Sanja Hogue, when I watched the promo video for this, her personality just radiates. Can you just tell me a little bit more about her?
Yeah, she is amazing. So charismatic, such a fun personality. And when she was asked by the president of Louisiana Tech to start the women's basketball program, she had never played basketball herself. She had played it in physical education class. She had gone to Louisiana Tech. She was a high school teacher that was overseeing the cheerleading program. And she was asked to start the women's basketball program. But because she was so resourceful, so charismatic, so visionary, all those things, she put together that program in a short period of time. She wrote the blueprint for how you create a national championship level program. And some of the greatest coaches that have coached our game either coached for her or played for her.
Kim Mulkey being one of them.
Kim Mulkey, one of them.
So many people, so many stories, so many connecting the dots between now and then. I'm so excited for it. If Not For Them is the title. It's going to be great.